A lot of tears and hugs as a Chicago man tasted freedom today for the first time in nearly three decades.
Damon Watson served time for a murder he says he didn't commit. He was released just hours after a judge vacated his conviction. WGN's Patrick Elwood has this emotional story.
Hi guys, good evening to you. To date, his life, he says, has been like a horror movie, but now it has a joyous twist. After almost 30 years, he has walked out of prison a free man. All the while, he says, he kept hope alive.
Go ahead.
It is the embrace that is 29 years in the making. Sentenced at 17, Damon Weston was convicted of murder and attempted murder.
Just to be free and no handcuffs, no shackles, nothing. Oh my God.
Today, with his conviction vacated, he walked out of the Dixon Correctional Center a free man.
The air is that much better on this side. I promise you that. I promise you.
Weston was convicted, he says, by way of a false confession, coerced under former disgraced Chicago police commander John Burge and officers who worked with him.
It's unbelievable right now. It's unbelievable. This shouldn't happen.
He says he was tortured. Burge is now deceased. After an in-depth review of the case, it was just yesterday that Cook County Circuit Court Judge Angela Patron made the ruling. Rita Srivastava, one of multiple attorneys from Chicago's Morgan, Lewis, and Bacchius, and paralegal Sarah Watson, worked to gain his release.
By the grace of God, he sent them my way. And, oh my God.
Today, as he sees the outside world that has changed in immeasurable ways since he first went in, Weston believes there is something that has not changed since almost three decades ago.
I'm not the first, and I'm definitely not the last, so hopefully other guys' day is coming too.
The Better Government Association estimates that John Burge wrongful conviction settlements have cost the city at least $551 million. Reporting from 51st and Wentworth, Area 1 Police Headquarters, Patrick Elwood, WGN News.
All right.